Good afternoon, all. We'll start today's class. Today, we are going to discuss about sociology as a science or not. Okay, is it a science? Or if it is a science, what are the conditions we say for? And if it is not a science, why it is not a science? Okay, we are talking about that. So it comes under chapter 2, sociology as science. Okay, so in chapter 1, we have finished modernity, emergent sociology we have done. We have done scope of sociology. Then we have done sociology and common sense. Then we finished sociology and differences like with economics, psychology, history, political science, anthropology we have done. So first chapter is done. So today we'll start a second chapter, sociology as science. So you can start drawing the flowchart with me and later on we'll get into the notes. Okay, first one is sociology a science or not? Sociology as science. That's our topic today. Okay. To get into this topic, I'll give you a flowchart or a structure that you can go through. And once you understand this structure, it will be very easy for you to write the answer as we do every day. Okay. First, you have to talk about the introduction. Okay. Why this debate has come. Introduction, as I told you, paper one, two chapters, when you have to quote introduction like sociology emerged in response to challenges posed before modernity in medieval Europe. And that is a standard introduction, first statement you have to add, because anything you're talking about sociology, you have to just add one statement saying that how it has evolved or where it has come. So that you have to add. And here we are talking about science. So start with our statement saying that the orientation of initial sociologists, this also we have discussed last class, the initial sociologists or the scholars wanted to align sociology in line with natural sciences. So I told you reasons, everything during that time. Just add this statement saying that they wanted to align in lines of natural sciences. And that time, a lot of revolutions were happening in scientific field. For example, astronomy, medical science, physics, biology, chemistry, all this revolutions or a lot of findings were coming in. And seeing all these things, what initial scholars of sociology thought that, okay, let us also make laws like this for sociology. So they were planned to generate similar universal laws of social organization in lines of natural sciences. Okay, that's the introduction you have to say. To talk about the emergence, you have to talk about the sociology. Initial sociologists wanted to align sociology in lines of natural science. Then talk about the other innovations, okay, or revolutions which happened in physics, chemistry, biology, all these things happen. So all these have motivated initial sociologists. Let us start making universal laws for sociology also. Why can't we make? So that concept was there. So that is the introduction of this debate. Okay. Then you have to talk about three thinkers. Not exactly three, but I'm giving you minimum this three you add, because they were the initial sociologists. So we are going to talk about Saint Simon, we are going to talk about Auguste Comte and Herbert Spencer. Okay, these three names are familiar to us. We were discussing these three names from the first class, so you should be knowing this. So Saint Simon, what he did, he was thinking about social physics, we know. Auguste Comte, father of sociology, 1838, even claimed to have developed universal laws of social organization. Auguste Comte have said that whatever laws I have made, it is he claimed to have made universal laws of social organization. Why universal laws? Because universal laws are laws which are made in science. Then only it will be accepted as science. So Auguste Comte claimed that, yes, I have also made some universal laws of social organization. And Herbert Spencer, we know his theory's name was organismic analogy. Organismic analogy. We know that he have compared organism and society. That chart also I have given you last class. Organism, society was divided into subsystems. Subsystems were divided into groups. Groups were divided into individual. I'm not explaining this in detail because you guys know it. That's why. And organization was further divided into organs. Okay, organs was divided into tissues, and tissues were divided into cells. We know that this was the concept of Herbert Spencer, and this theory's name is organismic analogy. Okay, so these are the three thinkers you can quote in first, because they were initial sociologists. These three wanted to align sociology in line with natural science. Okay, now what happens is that there were objections raised on the validity of these universal laws. These initial sociologists, these three people and few others have claimed that, yes, we are also making universal laws. So sociology is also similar to natural science. But what happened is that many people objected, saying, questioning about the validity of these universal laws. What is the validity that it is similar? Because you're dealing with society, and subject matter of society is individual. Individual, we can't predict how they react. It is not like same to natural science. For natural science, if you're studying an atom, you're studying a matter, we know that at this much temperature, this will react like this. And you know the matter changes everything. This is fixed. Wherever you go, there is inter-subject reliability. That means it is applicable at every sphere at same condition. But society, we are dealing with people. We can't predict how a person reacts at certain situations. So because of that, there were questions asking about, are your laws universally valid? So that was the context of debate. The question has come, is sociology a science or not? Is sociology a science or not? That was the debate came. Okay, so we are talking about the introduction. The initial thinkers are initial sociologists, three people we spoke about. And finally, debate has come like, is sociology a science or not? Okay, so our debate in this is purely based upon the understanding of the word science. So what is science linked to? Science linked to universal laws have to be there. Universal laws have to be made. There have to be empiricism, inductivism. I have told about empiricism, inductivism, everything last class. Inductivism and some reasoning have to be there, right? And logic. All these things are related to science. So there was a debate asking about whether sociology is a science or not. So a body of knowledge was considered as science during that time only if it yields universal laws and conforms to ideals of empiricism and inductivism. So if a law is told that, yes, it is natural science or it is linked to natural science, it has to be universal in nature. Empiricism have to be there and inductivism have to be there. So this was the definition during that time. So what happened is that subsequently, gradually, even after years and years, it has understood this. People started understanding that, okay, science, we have to understand more into a method of inquiry rather than a body of knowledge. That was a change happened. So please write it very clearly here. Science was later understood as a method of inquiry. This is the current situation. Okay. Now people understand science have to be a method of inquiry rather than a body of knowledge. We cannot claim that, okay, this is the body of knowledge which is abiding by empiricism, inductivism, logic, reasoning, evidence, everything I have. So it is, we can't say like that. So currently we say that, okay, it is not a body of knowledge. It is like a method of inquiry. Depending upon that, we'll define what is a science. Okay. Now, we will talk about the conditions of science. Okay. Introduction, we spoke, thinkers, we have spoken, then we came to science. And finally, we said that gradually it has come to a situation where science is understood as a method of inquiry rather than a body of knowledge. Okay. Then with time, what has happened is that there were certain conditions were laid down. Okay. If your theory is abiding by these conditions, then it is a science. Okay. So these conditions are there. Please write down these conditions. First one was inter-subject reliability. Inter-subject reliability. I don't have space here, so you have to put an arrow mark and write. Inter-subject reliability. Second one is objectivity. I'll explain in detail everything. Just write it down. Third one is quantifiability. Quantifiability. Fourth one is theory building. And fifth one is testing. So These are the conditions of science. First one is inter-subject reliability. What is inter-subject reliability? Inter-subject reliability means same meaning has to be conveyed to any number of people. Okay? If I'm developing a theory, I'm saying that it is science and it is applicable to everyone. It is all same. So what is the meaning of that? If I'm saying that inter-subject reliability is there, okay, inter-subject reliability is there, that means the meaning has to be same for me and you, correct? If science, because of science, we know that why rain is happening. You know that clouds are there, sky is cloudy, it is raining. So if I'm telling in phone, if you are in some other place, in your place, if it is not raining, if I'm telling in phone that, okay, it is raining here, you know what is rain. So for you and for me, this meaning has to be same. That is a science thing. Same thing we are telling that in sociology, if you are making a law, it has to be same for you and me. What I understand and what you understand has to be same. So first condition is in the subject reliability have to be there. Any broad way, any phases you take it, it has to be same for everyone. Okay. Second one is objectivity. Objectivity means what? Very simple. There is no preconception or no personal bias. It have to be neutral. The person's interest or person connection should not be there. It has to be very biasness should not be there. Unbiased conclusion have to be there in any theory. Then we say that theory is objective or objectivity is achieved. Third one is quantifiability. Quantifiability means what? If we have to measurable, okay? It have to be measurable. So in sociology, I know that I just told you that sociology deals with subject matter, actually with people, individual society we deal with. So it is very difficult to even think how we will quantify everything in society. But there are scholars like Durkheim who thought that we can quantify everything in society. Social facts he spoke about. Okay. We have a detailed theory about that. So you guys have to just note it down somewhere like this. And once you finish the theory chapter, then you will understand. Thinker's chapter, you will get a clear picture on this. Okay. Durkheim even said that social facts have to be considered as things and these things can be measured. Okay. So quantifiability is also applicable in sociology is what they are saying. Okay. Then theory building have to be there. That means what? Possibility of generalization have to be there. Whatever theory I'm making in sociology, if sociology is a natural science, it has to be applicable in every context. It should not change from one place to another. And last one is testing. It should be, I should be able to test. If you make some theory, I should be able to test and see if the result is same, cause and effect is same, same like natural science. So these are the five conditions of science which was laid down. Inter-subject reliability, objectivity, quantifiability, theory building, and testing. Okay, please note it down. I don't have space here. I would like to delete this. Okay. Please take 2 minutes and copy this. Introduction, thinkers, is sociology a science or not? Then we are talking about the science. Then science, we are now having an understanding that it's a method of inquiry rather than a body of knowledge. Then there are conditions laid down to talk about the science, that is inter-subject reliability, objectivity, quantifiability, theory building and testing. Okay. Now we have made all this. So whatever conditions we made, that is, what were the conditions? Inter-subject reliability have to be there, objectivity have to be there, quantifiability, theory building, testing. All these things, two things have evolved. Okay. There are people who came up with arguments in favor, saying that, yes, sociology is natural science. We are abiding by all these five things. Some people came that arguments against, saying that, no, we can't abide all these four rules. We cannot follow it properly. These five rules cannot be followed properly in sociology, so it will be difficult. So two schools have come up. Some people came, it is, yes, we can follow these five conditions of science. It is applicable in sociology, we can do that. And some people came up saying that, no, it is not possible. So we have to see, we have to write also what the arguments came in favor and what are the arguments came against. Okay, first we'll see what are the arguments came in favor. So I told you we have inter-subject reliability. In inter-subject reliability, it was said that concepts like, for example, sociology, we talk about family, religion, caste, etc. We talk about. So people said that, yes, it is possible because the meaning of family for me and for you is same. Religion for understanding about religion for you and for me and for third person is same. That means what? Sociologically, whatever we are studying theories, inter-subject reliability is possible is first thing. Second thing we spoke about, objectivity. So objectivity as it is may not be possible because sociology, what happens is that I told you subject matter of sociology. That means what we are studying in sociology is about individual or human beings or society or groups. So we don't know how, we can't predict their nature. We don't know how they will behave. So objectivity will not be there, will not be possible completely. So arguments in favor, we are talking 100% will not be possible, but by giving proper training to investigator everything, I can reduce my biasness. Objectively talk about bias, okay? I can reduce the bias. If I'm doing some investigation, if I'm studying something, what I can do is that I can reduce my personal interest interfering with the study I'm doing. I can keep it aside. That can be done if an individual is trained properly. So that was taken care of. Okay. Third one is about the quantifiability. Quantifiability, I already told the example of Emil Durkheim. Durkheim have said that even Durkheim's example, you can write. Even the extreme abstract forms in whatever we are finding in society that are social facts. Social facts have to be considered as things. Okay. Social facts have to be considered as things and things can be measured. Okay. So Durkheim have said that. So for therefore, quantifiability is possible there. Then we talk about theoretical orientation. We know that in sociology, nothing less in theories. There are a lot of theories in sociology. So theory building is possible. We have Marx's theory of historical materialism, Weber's theory of capitalism, Mead's theory of self, Durkheim's theory of division of labor, then suicide, religion, a lot of theories are there. There is nothing short of theories. So theory building is also possible. Then finally, testing, yes, we can test because entire society is a testing ground for sociologists. Sociology witnesses a large number of similar situations where the theories can be tested properly. So these are the arguments in favor or the school which said that, yes, sociology is a natural science. These five measures are there. It is applicable. Okay. Then there are some school people said that, no, it is not possible because there are issues in every stage. For example, in the subject reliability. Inter-subject reliability, because we are studying with individual, we cannot predict. Okay, so that is one negative thing. Then again, biasness, I told here only, personal interference will come. Even though we say that, okay, 100% the person is separated from the study he is doing, his personal interest will be there for the work he do. So his biasness will come, his interest will come. So that people said that, okay, that is also not possible. Then quantifiability also, things like feeling, hatred, anger, all these things, how will you measure? We have Mead's theory of self. We have all these individual theories. And even Weber have said that we have to understand the meanings attached by the actor to his action in order to understand the cause, arrive at the cause and effect relationship. So when we understand the meanings attached to the action, how will you measure the meanings? Individually, it will change. So people have argued saying that, no, all these things is not possible. Even testing, theory, building, everything, we have limitations. This is what arguments against have said. And finally, we came to a conclusion saying that sociology is not a science similar to natural science. That was our conclusion, but it's a science in itself. Please write it down. Sociology. Please write the statement as it is. Okay, it's a very important statement. Question can be asked by giving this statement simply. So you have to be very familiar with this statement. Sociology is not a science similar to natural science. Finally, what we concluded, sociology is not a science similar to natural science like physics, chemistry, biology. It is not a science similar to natural science, but it is a science in itself. Science in itself. Okay. It itself is a science. That was it. So the because we are ultimately we are studying about an individual. Okay. So we can't predict how the individual will behave. What is the end result? We cannot say. So, like in natural science, we cannot generalize by saying that sociology is not a science similar to natural science, but a science in itself. Okay, and we can conclude even by writing saying that currently we are in a situation where science we understood science as a method of inquiry rather than a body of knowledge. Okay, this is the conclusion you can write. This is about the sociology as science. Now we'll get into the notes. Okay, I'll tell you the structure once again. We'll talk about the introduction when we spoke about the thinkers. Okay, we spoke about Saint Simon, Auguste Comte, Herbert Spencer. Then we spoke about the science. Everything is debate is about the science. Then we spoke about the conditions. Okay, there are five conditions have to be there: objects, inter-subject reliability, objectivity, quantifiability, theory building, testing. And then we came into two suggestions like arguments in favor, arguments against. Finally, we came to a conclusion saying that sociology is not a science similar to natural science, but a science in itself. Okay, science can be understood as a method of inquiry rather than a body of knowledge. Okay, hope this is clear. Let's get into the notes. Yes. You can ask doubt once I explain about
Ma'am, if
the
it
you can ask doubt later, but let me finish the notes, then you can ask doubt. Okay, I'll give you 5 minutes. Okay, now sociology as science, whatever we have discussed, just written in the notes. So we have to write about sociology emerged as a distinct discipline. It is underlined here in response to challenges posed before modernity in medieval Europe. The orientation of initial sociologists was to develop sociology in lines of natural science. Okay, you know that. Develop sociology in lines so similar to natural sciences. There were many scientific revolutions in the field of astronomy, medical science, physics, biology, chemistry, which led intellectuals, that means what initial sociologists, to dream of a discipline which could generate similar laws of social organizations. Saint Simon even dreamt of social physics. Three thinkers we are quoting here: Saint Simon, Auguste Comte, Herbert Spencer. Auguste Comte, the founding father of sociology, 1838, claimed to have developed laws of universal laws of social organization. Similarly, Herbert Spencer, organism mechanology, was guided by the same assumption. So what happens is that objections were raised on the validity of the universal law developed by initial sociologists, and this initiated a debate on the nature of sociology, that is sociology a science or not. Okay, this is the introduction we have to write. What is the context of debate we are talking about? Okay, now basically the roots of this talk, everything is the word science. Okay, science is underlined here. It have to yield universal laws. Universal laws have to be there. Empiricism, inductivism, evidence have to be there. Reasoning have to be there. Systematic study have to be there. All these things have come. So the question has come whether all this is possible in sociology or not. Okay. Then there are some conditions for science. Conditions for science were laid out: inter-subject reliability, objectivity, quantifiability, theory orientation, theoretical orientation, and testing. Inter-subject reliability, we are seeing, I told you, it has to be convey same meaning for different people. Okay, that means for you, for me, for a third person, whatever sociology is saying, meaning has to be same. If that is the case, then sociology is a science. Okay, or similar to natural science, the concept should be defined precisely. Second one is objectivity. Personal biases and preconceptions should not be there. Okay, then it is not objective. So objectivity can be achieved if it is without personal biases and preconception. Quantifiability means, are you able to measure? Okay, subject matter should be clearly defined because it is not measurable as per the conclusion, because we are dealing with individuals. Individual cannot be measured. Feelings, hatred, love, anger, corruption, all these things we cannot measure. Then fourth one is theoretical orientation. The body of knowledge must be capable of generating theories. Mere collection of facts cannot be called as science. The possibility of generalization. Generalized theories have to be made. Okay, then we have one more point called testing. Fifth one, testing. It have to be ready for testing. So testing, society as a whole, we can test. in sociology. Okay, then arguments in favor and arguments against we are discussing. Arguments in favor I already discussed. Concepts like family, religion, groups, etc. have defined precisely and same meaning for all. We all understand family, religion, groups, everything in the same meaning. So that is possible, as people are saying. And they're saying like quantifiability, as I told you, Immanuel Durkheim's theory of social facts. He said that whatever we are finding in society, they are social facts and we can take things in the form of things and these things can be measured. Okay, quantifiability, in that point, you write the example of Immanuel Durkheim. Okay. Then although absolute objectivity is not possible, but sociology has ensured objectivity by using scientific methodology and proper training of investigators. I told you, people who are arguing in favor, they're saying that absolute objectivity, 100% objectivity, we can't, it is not possible, but we can reduce the biasness by using scientific methodology and a proper training of investigator. Investigator means a person or a scholar who is studying society. So we can give him proper training and use some scientific technology, everything we can give so that biasness can be reduced. So we can achieve objectivity. Theory building. Subject matter of sociology is capable of yielding many theories. We have historical materialism by Marx, Durkheim's theory of division of labor, Weber's theory of capitalism, Mead's theory of self, religion, suicide. We have many theories. So nothing short of theories in sociology. Then sociology uses methods and whole society testing. Whole society is a testing ground for sociologists. A larger number of similar situations in which theories can be tested. This is just a note of what we have said. Okay, now arguments against. Arguments against, actually you can write from these points only. How do you write against these points? Inter-subject reliability is not possible because we are dealing with individuals, right? Objectivity is not possible because person is doing. Investigator is a person. Obviously his interest will come. So objectivity is also not possible. Quantifiability, how you measure feelings, meaning, etc. That is not possible. For example, you can talk about Weber. He spoke about meanings attached by the actor to his action. Is it possible to measure the meaning? Not possible. So quantifiability is also, we can say, theoretical orientation and testing. Society as a whole, subject matter sociology itself is human being or individual, so it is difficult. Okay. And conclusion, we are saying that sociology is not a science similar to natural science, but a science in itself. We cannot say it is similar to physics, chemistry, or biology, but it is similar to science. It's a science in itself. It is not similar to natural science, but a science in itself. Okay. Science is not a body of knowledge, but a study of phenomena or a method of inquiry. You can add the statement method of inquiry or investigation. Science is understood as a method of inquiry rather than a body of knowledge. This is the conclusion you can say. Okay. That's it. So now you can ask doubts.
Ma'am, if it is a 10 mark question, then yes, the process of writing is same, or
if 10 marks a question, what you can do is that introduction you can limit to two sentences. By we can say just emergence in one sentence and just say talk about the thinkers directly. Say that initial thinkers like Saint Simon, Auguste Comte, Herbert Spencer wanted to align social. You don't want to write detail about each theories, okay? Because we will not have the space for that. Then directly you come to how the debate has evolved. Debate has come asking about the validity of these questions. Then debate has come asking, is sociology a science or not? Then talk about the conditions that is laid down to be followed, the five conditions, arguments in favor and small paragraph, arguments against and conclusion. You can finish like that.
Ma'am, the conclusion that sociology is not a science similar to natural science, but it is a science in itself. What is the difference between that? It's not similar, but it's a science in itself.
Okay, it is similar. It is not similar to natural science because we have said that there are five conditions have to be satisfied if it has to be natural science. is sociology abiding by all these five conditions? No, sociology is not able to follow these five conditions clearly. So it is not natural science, but it is a science in itself. Why we are saying science in itself? Because we have a statement coming that sociology is understood as a body of method of inquiry rather than a body of knowledge. Sociology have a different way of studying. We also do scientific investigation. We also do objectivity. We also make theories. We also do testing, everything. We do everything. So we are also a science. We are also a method of inquiry. We are not simply making theories. We are using these methods and making theory. But end result is not like other disciplines. We are a science, separate science. Science in itself, not natural science. That is the meaning.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, I hope you guys are clear. I'm only discussing this topic today. Tomorrow we'll discuss about problem of objectivity and value neutrality. I'll share these notes in the group.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I have one general doubt.
Yes.
Like how we should present our answer. Should we write in paragraph form or in the form of points?
No, sociology, you are advised to write in paragraphs. Okay, because it's a humanity subject. It is same like it is not a natural science. Okay, it is a human science in itself. It's a different science. You are a sociologist. A sociology is expected answers in paragraphs. You can remember these flowcharts and all. It will make your life easy by remembering things. Okay, after this you have to write this. After this point you have to bring this point. You will remember. But you can also draw in your answers. There is no problem in that. But whatever you are writing, write in paragraphs. And continuation have to be there. One paragraph, you say something. Continuation, the next paragraph. So a flow have to be there. But paragraphs are preferred.
Okay.
Yeah.
With the help of the rules, we are comparing the whether it is social, whether it is science or
not. Yeah.